Welcome to Leg Up Australia podcast, episode 13. Boys,
put your hand down, Blake.
What's
doing? Yeah, boys, we're back.
You didn't do those kicks. I told you to do some kicks to get fired up. You've come
clap.
In a little bit.
I did a clap.
You did a clap. You've come in a little bit down.
Down?
You're right.
Didn't go about 0 from 6. Warren Farm today. That'll get you down.
That'll do it.
Oh,
tough week. By who?
Tough week.
The mighty Titans. Mighty Titans.
The bloody Titans. Manly's, if you're just a little bit off this season,
yeah,
you get done.
Yeah, they scored the first 2 tries, Manly. They went no good.
They went no good. The ball didn't bounce their way, I would suggest.
That seems to always
and still, the Titans just...
That seems to always be the case for Manly.
No, it is not.
It was
Titans,
just bad luck.
The Titans just picked up every ball that went to the ground, like, you know, that sort of stuff. But that's
hungry.
All Manly, because we weren't there. We expected to win, and we didn't. They were just there. They were just too good.
This week
you guys were too good for us,
eh? Yeah, I loved it. Brenko Lee. Did he play on that?
Brenko.
Maybe not anymore.
I did not watch the game.
Tyrone Roberts.
Yeah, the Don was good.
Peach. The Peach.
Hey, did the Don end up getting a run in the Origin
side? Is Don good?
No, he didn't.
Is Don not good enough?
I'm going to tell you something. I actually played with Anthony Don once.
Okay, well.
Who did in the...
I played with him as well.
In the Schoolboys?
Yeah.
He said he was his winger.
Yeah, no, well, he was fullback when I played.
Oh,
yeah. So he got the little upgrade. Hildo was probably playing fullback that year.
Mate.
For the Quakers.
A slimmer, smaller build of the Hildo.
Hey, there is a very, very good chance we're going to have Luke Hilton, champion trainer, on the podcast next week. So stay tuned for that one. He's what were you saying beforehand? He's actually perfect for this podcast because...
Oh, he covers, like, our staples, racing, AFL and NRL. Hildo is a horse trainer. He's played AFL. Park style, like for a team, but...
Yeah, but he's strapped on the shorts and run out.
Yeah, he's played. And NRL, he represented... he did schoolboys... No, he's played Jersey Flag.
So did you play schoolboys... Did you and Hildo play football together?
We played
footy
together.
We destroyed it,
Quakers Hill.
Yeah.
We didn't play together with Anthony Dawn. But we played in the same team, just in different years.
Ah, okay. So who played with Don? You did.
We both did. But he played...
2 years.
Both
separately.
2 years in a row.
Actually, and I'm going to go one further with the Hildo. The very, very first sport, and I've played a fair few sports with the Hildo, I played with him. Take a punt, BJ.
Was it on New Year's Eve?
No, not that year. I got him to run at me a lot.
Basketball?
No, but I played basketball with him.
Yeah, we played basketball.
So he's played basketball as well.
Yeah,
we played
a little
soccer together. That was the very first sport we played together. He was our goalkeeper. He is... You know,
he is the Molly Sport. So
don't say that, Sam. He didn't cover the whole goal.
Not at that point. He was still playing representative footy at that time. So.
Stay tuned for next week.
I got one more thing. Did he belt you that night that you told him to run at you?
No way.
Bullshit.
I'm still here.
You put him on your back. Put him on his back. Did you?
I kept going back though, didn't I?
I'll get him on the channel for the page.
Sorry?
We're going to run at each other for the page.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Beautiful.
That could go viral.
Yep. The run at me challenge. Hashtag.
Hashtag run at Gordy.
So, what's been going on? Big week?
Massive week.
Yeah?
Big week.
Boat show? Tell us about the boat show.
Boat show was on last weekend.
Did you buy a boat?
Took the wife. No, it wasn't a purchasing outing. It was a reconnaissance mission, really, more than anything. Had the wife.
Look and feel.
Had a look.
You must have been backing a few winners lately, Boogie.
Me?
Yeah, buying a boat, please. He was looking at
that sponsorship for the sponsorship deal for the leg ups come through.
34 yards.
Just to, you know, we haven't seen any done.
No, we just got a leg up boat.
Now we're
it's all looking good. Hopefully by the end of this weekend we've got some good news regarding boating.
We'd like you punters to write in. We're trying to get a petition signed that he gets his boat signed as the leg up. That would look good. What about that picture today, BJ?
Yeah, I liked it. It's either going to be called
up photo.
The Legger or Gen D?
Gen D.
Right. From Forest Camp.
Also feel like the purchase of the boat probably makes that decision. But the leg up's a very good chance of getting a sticker at some point on the boat.
It needs a sticker.
Not one of the stickers we currently have.
Yeah, this one.
The
back of the apple.
The currently...
On the back of the apple.
What other dimensions for a current leg up sticker. They're about sixty mil by.
Yeah, they're about 50 by 60 mil.
They're not going to see much on a six meter boat with a tiny.
We need at least twice that size.
This will be at least 2 times as big as this.
It'll be covered in bloody blood and guts and all stuff. Yeah.
That's the plan.
Speaking of, I've started prenatal classes.
Did you watch the video?
This is going to be. Anyone that's listening to this knows exactly what I'm talking about. It's the first. We didn't even get to watch the full birth video. I still saw stuff that I didn't think I wanted to see.
You've seen plenty of videos of before the birth. Like how conceived in the birth.
They always cut this part out.
Did it scare the shit out of you?
No, not really. Like, it's pretty amazing, like, what women do, but it, like, my wife was sitting there going, oh, yeah, oh, okay. Yep, I'm sitting there thinking, if this was me, I would be scared shitless. Because it's like, and then you're going to go through this many contractions and they hurt this much, and that's only 6 hours worth. And then this, and then you're going to go through some real intense ones. But it's only for 3 hours, but you get breaks in between. So really, it's only like being in the worst pain of your life for an hour straight. But that's like 10 hours already into the labor. So it was, you know what? I'm very glad I'm not a woman first to give birth.
Me too.
I've got no comments on this at all.
What do you mean? Never had a baby.
Never had a baby. I wouldn't even try to cut the pair of anything.
Oh, mate. It's silly. It's pretty, it's eye-opening, absolutely. But, yeah. Scary.
I'm happy with our part.
What's your part?
That part.
Standing in the waiting room.
What do you call that room?
No, you've got to be in there.
Waiting room.
So you won't even go in.
I'm not very good with blood, but yes.
Not very good is a.
Okay, so if your lovely wife was giving birth, are you up the business end or are you up her end?
No, I'm up the top end.
Okay.
I'd be at the top end for sure.
You just said you're not even in the room.
Blake was next door.
He's like those old school like guys who used to sit out the front smoking cigars, like, it's a boy, yeah.
I was nearly unconscious once at the pub when I cut my finger.
That is that boy? Sure, yep.
That's impressive.
I don't know how
you're going to get through birth.
There's a little nick on my finger. I'll even tell you, Hildo is...
Who's Nick?
Hildo was involved in this story.
Oh, shit.
Because
we're 8 minutes in, we've mentioned Hildo 42 times.
Yeah, he'll love it.
Lucky he's coming in next week, yeah. So...
It's like the biggest segue. It's a segue.
No, I'll tell you now, because it won't make next week's show, but I was bleeding pretty profusely.
Good enough for this show,
finger.
But not the Hilt one.
And Hildo was, like, he had a little swab, and he was, like, holding that on my finger. And then when he was putting the Band-Aid on my finger, he had the bloody swab in his mouth. So he's not the most hygienic nurse in the world.
No.
But he is a good man.
Yeah.
How did you guys pull up from touch?
I'm not as sore as the week before.
I ran this morning, so I'm all right. Yeah.
Where'd you run to?
How far did you run?
5Ks.
5Ks.
What's your marathon update?
Marathon's going good. I ran today as well.
How far?
6.5.
Nice.
It's only like having to do 8 times more than.
No, less, but still a lot.
Six and a half to seven times.
Well, that's alright. I felt like at the end of it I could go 7 times.
I could do that six more times.
So just go 6.5 and then I feel good about myself. So I just want to go into this marathon feeling really good about myself. I don't want to get close and be like, oh, that was really tough. I want to go in with the right mindset, you know?
Yeah. Hey, speaking of touch, do we play, that Middle Origin is on a Sunday night, game 2.
Yeah, I think that's right.
Do we cancel touch?
We don't cancel touch for anything.
I'm not going to go
to
work that
day. Why would we cancel touch?
Because I like to really enjoy Origin.
Do you take the Thursdays off after Origin?
Mostly. Mate, you don't see how much I celebrate Origin.
You couldn't be much slower than you on Monday night.
They were cocky.
They were cocky. Boy, you didn't think they were cocky. But
a bloke ran around me at some point And he knew I was that slow. He went, made that noise. I thought, well, that's a bit much.
What a douche.
Well, what?
Douche.
Well, that's not a term.
It's a term. It's in the dictionary. Look it up.
Okay, douche.
they had a little bit on us, but I literally, that was not a try that they gave me. I ran over the dead ball.
Oh, yeah.
Straight. And you went out.
He ran over the dead ball.
Oh,
and then everyone chirped up from the sideline. It's like, shut up.
Yeah, they were dickheads.
Douches.
They were douches.
Douches.
I did a couple of phantom touch calls, which is... But I wouldn't have
did
done
Did you
that.
Really?
I did.
Oh, you're a... You're
that.
A cheat.
Yeah.
Do you do phantom touch calls as well?
No. I don't mean to, but I go close to them and I'm like, yeah.
You do them as well.
I just said, I'm a honesty, mate.
Oh.
32 years of honesty.
See this
behind me.
Nah.
If I get them, they know.
You know, but you know if you touch someone.
I felt like I touched them a few times, you know?
That's it.
I felt like I might have touched you.
Tell that to the judge.
Oh,
he was on
wow.
my side, that referee. He was good to us.
Yeah,
he
was.
He's not a bad guy.
We got beat 7-3.
Mm.
So it was a big improvement from week one.
They had twice as many subs as us. They were going on. Like, they just won the grand final.
Yeah,
and
their average age
would have
been 5 years younger than ours. So
they've
got things that's speedy and all the rest
of it.
They
were speedy.
They looked cool dudes too.
They're a bit cool.
Barry's one of them I
like.
Yeah, scored off
we should
kicks. They got him behind us.
I need to do more kicks.
You need to do more kicks.
Yeah.
Anyway.
It's like chip and chases for you.
Will you be taking off next Thursday when game one, the State of Origin, kicks off?
No, but we need to organise what we're doing actually. It's probably not. Conversation for the podcast.
Do you understand that I've been just trying to throw to this frigging game for the last 5 minutes? Oh, yeah, we didn't figure out what we're doing. Oh, yeah, back to touch.
Do you want
to
talk about Origin?
Mate, it is the biggest thing on the sporting calendar right now.
Yeah, it's massive.
I cannot wait.
It's on everyone's lips except the Queensland team who aren't allowed to talk about the Blues, apparently. Some heavy Walters thing.
How ridiculous.
I just saw before that I think that implied like a. It's almost like a Bucks party, which they hope it's probably the opposite, but.
It could very well
That's the New South Wales Blues camp a couple of years ago. Apparently, there's like a fine system if you mention the opposition or whatever. You just have to say the other team or something. You can't say New South Wales or Blues or something like that. I don't know.
Yeah, you can't mention the other team. That's
ridiculous.
I would go with Sam Wood.
You ever had any. I know you want to talk about Origin. But, like, any tactical things from your coaches about that sort of... Is that getting the mindset for your teams? No?
No.
Because that don't make sense.
There was that... We actually spoke about one of the early episodes when Adelaide lost to Richmond. When Richmond came out.
Richmond!
Yeah.
And then at the training camp, they played the Richmond song. And
over and over again.
Yeah.
It took a record break.
That didn't work out too well for them last year, but yeah, I don't know anything like that.
Yeah. Oh,
when
we
played,
happens.
Like it was more about trying to put like DP in people's jocks, and they pull their jocks out. It's like they run to the field, it's like you dogs, like who did it? That awful feeling when you're like, that's hot.
Yeah, that's hot. In my jocks.
Someone's put DP in my jocks.
You don't want DP in your jocks.
How do you know?
Let's talk a little bit of Origin then.
Yeah, talk to me about key outs, because we have spoken about it a couple of times the last couple of weeks in the podcast about how I don't think they'll pick Ferguson for culture.
Furcoat's out.
They didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was one of the... So the team I put out, my 13, was similar. It was the same as Freddy's except for two.
Yeah.
I had Fergo, and they've got Nick Kotrick. Fergo, is he just out of favour with Freddie? Is it a little bit of a personality thing, do we think?
Well, Freddie wasn't coach when he did that stuff down at Kingsgate Hotel.
No.
That was Laurie.
Yeah.
So, why would he be out of favour for him?
No, I'd suggest he's not. Freddie wants the future.
Is Kotrick the future?
Fergo's been sensational, though.
Kotrick's been great as well.
Yeah.
It's a tough one. I'm putting it out there.
Mm-hmm.
I like Queensland. I reckon Queensland will win.
Oh, mate, I really hope
Who do you support?
They got this bloke...
Oh, here we go.
Queenslander!
Are you doing a full flip here? You're going to go for Queensland?
No, I'm blue.
Then what did you say that for?
Can we talk about Daly Cherry Evans?
Yeah, let's talk about him.
I love him. He's in the team. How long have you not played football for?
3 months.
A month, something like that.
Okay,
3 weeks.
That's
3 weeks.
That's good going into it.
And he's always done well before for Origin. He has been... He sounds like a knock, but...
It's a flip.
No. He's been... Because of his ankle, he's worried that, you know, he could re-injure it at home. So he's moved out of his family home. Moved out, like, left his wife, their kids. I think they have four. I don't know. But he's moved in with his in-laws so he can have a bit of peace and quiet, get that ankle ready and get his head right for Origin.
That's the dumbest thing
I've ever seen.
To footy.
That's dedication.
To footy.
Not to your wife.
Not to your wife. Yeah. Priorities.
41st for DCE.
Yeah.
What a man.
I feel like that's the wrong... I disagree with that. I'm saying not a good precedent. How about you? Pregnant. Your wife's pregnant. You're like, yeah, big game coming up. You're just going to hold it up.
I would expect you to leave Elise...
If
you had an ankle injury and the touchdown comes up.
If I left her, she would kill me. Like,
yeah.
Like, that's just isolate that statement.
Sounds like a good deal for her almost.
Leave me. So yeah, that's a bit weird. So let's go through this New South Wales lineup.
Alright, let's have a look. I'm interested here.
There was never going to be any other conversation around the fullback.
Tedesco's always there.
Yeah. Had O'Carr. He hasn't been as electric this year as he was last season.
Probably not. But he's still very good. He's there.
So tell me, you know, I actually haven't had a good look at these teams until tonight. So who's debutants?
For New South Wales, we've got Kotrick.
Yeah.
Cody Walker from the first 13. Then Angus Crichton played last year, didn't he?
White and Haas.
And Murray. Yeah, so the three interchange players plus Kotrick and Walker.
How many NRL first grade games did Payne Haas play?
9 or 10, I think.
Yeah, not many.
That's got to be some sort of...
It will be the record now, because I think Freddie Fittler had the record before and he played 11. Something like that. They were talking about it last week.
There's been a few blokes that have been thrown right in the deep end.
Mm.
And Payne Haas is one of them. Cody Walker. Do you know Cody Walker debuted at 26?
I didn't know.
Left Bloomer.
That's pretty cool.
How old have we been at?
28. He's been around for a couple
of years. So, do you reckon... I know you were a Cody Walker fan. You wanted him in the... Actually, no. I listened to last week's podcast a little bit today. And you had... Kiri in there, he's got the jersey, no doubt, and you had Cody Walker on the bench.
Yes.
Do you think, because this is my opinion, I reckon that Cody Walker has got the jump because of Kiri's... He's had two HIAs in a row now, hasn't he? Back-to-back weeks, I reckon.
Yeah, so
he went out in second or third minute last week, maybe.
He's going to miss a game now, doesn't he?
I think he's gone.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah, 100%, he was picked.
Yeah, I think he was too. I think he'd been...
So Jack White probably comes into the side because of it. Cody Walker probably had that bench.
Yeah, I think you're right.
But, Cody Walker's got a good head on his shoulders. Let me, who do you think's got a better core? Like, 1, 6, 7, 9, and 13?
You said the Bars.
You think the Blues?
I think when you...
I think
put them together... Like, maybe individually, but you know, how are you going
to... Yeah, let's keep going down that path, boy, because I tend to agree.
Okay, let's look at Queensland, 1, 6, 7, 9, 13. You've got Ponga from Newcastle. You've got Cameron Munster, Daly Cherry Evans, Ben Hunt, and then Josh Maguire.
Yeah,
I just don't rate Josh Maguire.
Not many of these blokes have played alongside each other. Ben Hunt and Maguire would have.
Yeah.
At Broncos.
Yeah, and Queensland last year.
And Queensland
Munster
last
and
year.
Maguire last year.
Just Queensland last year.
Yeah, and Queensland, so not, you know, and how much do you really sort of get to know their play over that sort of, those three games in that week and a half per game? Oh, I understand you're going to get to know a bit. Then you go New South Wales, you've got well, this is going to be, this isn't going to end up a great example now, but Tedesco, Cody Walker, Cleary, Damien Cook, Jake Trbojevic, you've got your seven, oh, sorry, your six and your nine, who are probably going to be playing pretty close, who are living in each other's pockets day to day. Not so much anyone else, but I just, I don't know, I think I like them as a bit more team players than there's probably more individual brilliance in the core of Queensland.
Yeah, I wouldn't disagree. I just, you're a Panther supporter.
Mm.
Nathan Cleary, how's his kicking game been this year? It needs to be spot on.
His kicking's been good.
His kicking's been pretty good.
Everything else hasn't been good.
No, I don't know about everything else, but it looks like last year, this time last year, this time last year we were talking about him being able to, like, make really big plays that he's not expected to, like, you know, last-ditch tackles and, you know, taking on the biggest guys and stuff and having really, really strong defence. This year I've seen his defence probably isn't as strong, but I don't think he's at a point where if you compare him to other halfbacks in other teams, that he's like, oh, he's going horrible. I think he just kind of was going really good this time last year.
It's hard to go good in a side that's going no good.
But if you are going good, you usually stand out. That's why I don't think he has had a lot going for his game this year.
But that's what I'm going to say is, like, last year in Origin, he was flying pre-Origin, all right? Then in the Origin, he did his job.
Yeah.
He didn't do anything.
Yeah,
his job.
He's there and he's got a kick in the box. Yeah.
Kicked well, he made his tackles, passed the footy. He didn't do anything. Like, he wasn't man of the series, or you'd give him a
seven. Did anyone give Billy Slater man of the series last year?
Slater got man of the series. Yeah, that's fair.
We had a podcast last year so we could
spray that. Should have been DCE.
Oh, yeah.
I just don't think
he's in a dreamland.
Big pressure, like he was going good into it last year and he got probably a 7 out of 10. He's going no good this year. What's he going to do in the game? It's interesting.
It's definitely interesting, but I think that, you know, the combination of he gets to get the ball off the back of some forwards that should know what they're doing. Like this year the Panthers have just been really in disarray. Like, it doesn't give him much. They haven't really got any good roles on or been able to build pressure and get him to sort of kicking those corners and stuff. It's almost like everything they've been doing is like rushed and unorganized. So I'd like to think that he comes back into this and feels maybe a bit more confident.
But he really
I hope he plays his best game.
He really needs to steer the ship because
Cody Walker
is not going to steer the ship.
Yeah, no.
Cody Walker will run around and.
So I think Damien Cook takes a big part in this now.
Cookie, it's not his job though.
No,
it's
not.
50 tackles a game, it's not your job to steer the ship. It's
but also, he's going to play the role of Cameron Smith. Melbourne or a Queensland.
Yeah, that being said, like, Cam Smith, you don't see him take off like Cookie does. Like, Cookie will get tackled and he'll run from dummy half and he'll come out the other side and do that sort of stuff. So he can't control a game like Cameron Smith can. So I do think it's on Cleary's back. So he just needs to steer the ship, basically.
I've got my fingers crossed for him.
What do you reckon, Woodette?
Why is Kieran not in the team? Do we already say that?
He's injured.
HIA.
He's got it.
What about Frizzell? We should have HIA. He got smashed.
He's got a very tough head.
Mm. He is granite, that bloke. He is absolutely granite.
Hopefully, Kiri will be alright. When's he suspected to come back for the Roosters?
I'm not sure. I haven't looked at that, actually. what do you like then? I suppose you sort of mentioned you like the core. What's your overall on the Queensland side there, Jack?
I think good.
And then I'll go to Woodhead being Queensland supporter, of course.
I didn't expect this good a side. Like, looking at it on paper, coming into this, I was thinking, oh, Blues and Morals. But now looking at the Queensland side on paper, I don't like the selection of Cleary in the New South Wales side.
DC
being fit.
You would have had Reynolds?
I would have had Reynolds for sure. Or anyone else who's in form. I would have even preferred Mitchell Pearce because he's absolutely flying. But I do like the Queensland side. I think they're going to be hard to beat. I just am excited. It's going to go down to the wire. Either side, 1-6.
If, I was going to say, if one team wins by 1 or 2 points, who is it?
Queensland.
Yeah.
I'm still with Queensland to win.
Okay.
The close game.
I think, and this is my kind of whole thought on this team, is it's interesting. We've got to see what they're like when they're out there. But that Queensland bench, there's some big bodies on that bench.
Mbai?
The other three are pretty big bods.
Yeah, that
makes Mbai's probably bigger than all of us anyway.
Well, Moses is an interesting selection.
Yeah, I'll ask you that.
Did not see that coming. But I think if they manage those big boppers well, bring them in late in the halves or late in the game, especially if it is close, I think they can do some damage.
Yeah,
especially Big Pappy.
You look at Queensland's interchange, and they've gone for Cam Murray, Angus Crichton, Jack White, and you've almost got a proper utility and two more that are kind of half utilities.
Yeah.
I mean, they're not they're good back rowers, but they're pretty versatile players as well, I think.
Definitely.
Is it the classic brains versus brawn?
No. I'm going to go with no. But you know how you said who wins?
You tried not to shut
me
down,
yeah.
So I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I just reckon the Blues are like, if Queensland are thereabouts, they have that mentality like...
Oh, they always seem to scrape it.
They're going to... Like, I think the Blues, if they get into that situation, they're like, oh, not again. Not again.
There's one bloke we haven't mentioned.
Hilda.
Who...
Oh wait, sorry. Only five.
Luke Hill. There's one bloke we haven't mentioned that Queensland don't have, and that's Latrell Mitchell, who is a proper game changer.
Mm.
Because Latrell is probably the only person on that, you know, those 40, 34 players that can come out and score 2 or 3 tries in Origin. First 2 or 3 tries in Origin. He's just...
He'll score a try.
He'll be
he
the...
Should score
he,
a try.
He, if New South Wales win, he'll be the difference. You've got to... There's no one else that stands out and no one else that I can remember that really stood out like that.
I'm excited. It's...
Yeah, I can't wait. It's going to be great.
Queensland actually firmed up a little bit, so...
Oh, I was going to that just quickly.
$2.05 for the Queenslanders.
It's about right.
Can I get a Queenslander?
Queenslander!
Can I get a Queenslander from you?
You do what?
No.
Come on.
Did you guys listen, when you listened to last week's podcast, did you hear me do a wolf call?
I heard the wolf.
No, I didn't listen to
it. It sounded like a proper
woo!
It's better than that. It's heaps better than that.
A woo!
Okay.
I apologise
to everyone. To everyone's ears for that one.
Yeah. Stick with us, please.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do that again. Enough Origin?
Yeah, well.
Shall we change the...
We're going to talk after Origin, like not... We're going to talk right after Origin like next week. So
yeah, we're talking.
Very excited to,
after Origin,
to get on that. But we.
Let's change the pace a little bit. We'll go to a slower game.
I'm going to be honest with you. There's nothing. As much as I love Aussie rules, there's nothing on a national scale for me that beats. In fact, Origin's probably the best sporting spectacle aside from. For me personally, Anzac Day,
I knew it was
and
Anzac
possibly the AFL Grand Final, that
and its Origin,
so good. I love Origin. I absolutely love Origin.
Stop talking about it. Let's talk about some AFL.
Mm-hmm.
We have seen someone on the chopping block.
Yeah, first head coach.
Yeah, 10 rounds in.
Yeah, 10 rounds in. It's kind of a weird one, actually. So Brad Scott is the head coach of the North Melbourne Football Club. He's been with them for 10 years, and this was his 10th season.
Long 10 service. Years is a long time.
Massive. And I also, in regards to what kind of coach he was, his winning games was 106, and his losing games was 105. So he went out as a winning coach.
Yeah, 50-50, just about. That's a lot of, like, if you looked at Wayne Bennett's stats in the NRL, they wouldn't be that much better, I'd go with. I reckon he'd be about 55, 45.
Yeah, he would probably be different because he's
that's my guess.
Coached 1,000 games.
Oh my god.
You get that Bennett?
Go to the computer.
I'll keep going with this bloke just to give him a bit of background. So he why this is weird. So North are having a bad year. He was probably the three coaches you thought were going to lose their coach, their jobs were probably Carlton, Brent Bolton, possibly Simon Goodwin, so Melbourne, Essendon, John Worsfold. I kind of think this surprised everyone a little bit. But so where this gets a little bit murky is, so in round five, he had a meeting with the board at North Melbourne, and they said, look, we're going to give you to the end of the year. He said to them, look, if you think the right thing for me to do is step down, I will step down at the end of the 2019 season. That happened in round five. Last week, one of the board members supposedly leaked this story to the media, which brought this whole thing under speculation. And basically, there was an article written Friday last week by Robbo. You know, your man that you're not really sure on.
Yeah,
Robbo.
360. Yeah, yeah.
So he's the chief footy writer for the
Herald. He's got a little bit of
flavor saver. You know what they call
Robbo?
Like
Robbo, mate.
Shannon Knowles. Yeah,
you know what they call that? Flavor saver. Down the streets? Tickler.
The tickler. Yeah, the tickler. Okay. That was probably... I didn't get mentioned, but anyway. Please move on. For anyone who's not here, Woodhead is rubbing his flavour saver on his microphone.
So Robbo broke the story about all this. Brad Scott was basically leaving the club Friday arvo. The CEO called him and said, hey, this is out in the public, we should probably finish you up tomorrow.
Pack your stuff.
Yeah, so...
Trudeau weekend!
So, he was quite devastated, but it actually takes another... So, it's quite odd seeing a coach, knowing that this is his last game that he's coaching, it's not the end of the year. But, so Brad Scott was a very good player for Brisbane Lions. He was a part of their triple premiership. Him and his brother, who is the coach of Geelong, probably the dirtiest players I've ever seen. They'll always be in my books as the grubbiest players I've ever seen.
What did they used to get up to?
They used to do a lot of, both of them would team up people to fight. I remember Nick Riewoldt played in a game, fractured two of his fingers. Went off, they strapped it, came back on, and then Brad Scott decided they would try and punch his hand as often as they could.
Walking back to the mark,
they'd just be like, yeah, and then punch his hand. So,
I want to shake hands?
Yeah, they're dogs.
Any hoppers?
Huh?
Any hoppers?
No, I don't know. Well,
not quite that dirty.
I don't know. Yeah, the NRL has just got that over everyone. So he was a Brisbane Lions player, came to North Melbourne, been there for 10 years. North Melbourne pride themselves on Arden Street culture, which is where it's based, the shinboner spirit, which is what it's called. Now, like I said, this takes another turn. So during his final game, he was running out to address his players at quarter time and shoulder charged a boundary rider, like a bloke from the media.
Oh, I saw it. I don't know if he shoulder charged.
No, but it doesn't matter.
Did
if
he glance? It was a glance.
He
did.
Got
it.
Like, it wasn't like it wouldn't have hurt him. Like, it'd be like you calling a touch.
Me what?
When you didn't touch it.
Yeah, like a false touch. So it was like their jackets rubbed. But
yeah.
From front on, you saw the footage.
Yeah.
So it looked like he was trying to, and then...
Oh, there's plenty of room to avoid him.
Oh,
and
take
his beelines at.
It's a 300-metre field.
Yeah, that's true.
And then he mouths stuff that you don't know. I can't really tell what it is, but then it ends with effing C.
Yeah.
So...
That bit was well printed.
Yeah, very... I was surprised they just kept showing that. Clipping a media personality on the way out, like literally trying to clip him. But the background of that is David King, the media personality, ex-footballer, great analyst for Fox Sports. He played at North Melbourne, and has always been critical of Brad Scott.
Not a fan.
Not a fan. At one last week or 2 weeks ago, he called him a visitor because he doesn't understand the culture.
But DC in Queensland,
he's a visitor.
Different story.
Not anymore.
Well, not. We'll see. Like DC in Queensland, if DC had been playing for Queensland for the last 10 years.
Yeah, that's true.
He's had his chance, Brad Scott.
Yeah.
10 years.
What's the best they've done under Brad Scott? Have they had
two prelims? Two prelim finals. And then I think they finished fourth twice and eighth twice. So
yeah, pass much. That does just say something like 50%, which then brings me back to just very quickly, Wayne Bennett, he runs about 65%.
Does he really? That's very good.
That's
how many games is that?
That was pre this
6,
season.
6,000, right.
And they're now top of the table. Oh, sorry, we've gone with, they're wrong. Oh,
it's wrong.
Sorry, Benno, you're back at 50%.
What, how many games did he catch?
Oh, this is back end of 2018, so it doesn't count the 11 where he's won
one
and
he's
lost.
No,
so it's higher. No, because they're top of the table, Blake. That's up to 631 games.
Far out, that's good.
Yeah, so he's nearly 650 now.
He's won more games than Brad Scott.
Just check his stats.
Okay, we'll do a fact check.
Yeah, you. NRL.com.
Yeah, whoever you are.
What's the stat guy's name? What's his name?
Who?
The bloke, the NRL stat guy.
True man.
David Middleton.
Middleton.
Check your stats, Middleton.
Get your head right, Middleton.
The loser.
Yeah, so that was interesting. Hey, some not very good news came out this morning for Jack DeBell.
Yeah, we're back to... We're back to almost pre-season stuff.
JDB.
Sorry, you go. I was going to say, when I read the when I first read the headline, I went, oh, God, maybe, you know, some people have seen...
Yeah, clickbait.
And then they've gone,
I thought that too.
Oh, some people have seen and gone, look, I'm going to come forward as well. As it's turned out, it's the same incident. There's the extra additional charges are the same incident, the same person. It just... I don't know the legal system, but that's what it is.
So what?
So it's the same person, the same event. It's just that there's some, I don't know, they somehow break it up into this happened and now these two things also happened in that same event. So I don't know. I don't really want to say too much about it.
I just don't understand. So he's up on one count of rape that he pleaded not guilty to in February.
Mm-hmm.
But today he's being hit by two new rape charges over the same incident?
Apparently. That's what I read.
That is interesting.
I don't understand that. But imagine if you played the whole time. So imagine if you had a bloke that's entering, what are we in, round 11 or 12, 12 for the, 12,
yeah,
for the NRL?
Yeah.
And he's 12
he'd
games
be playing Origin.
The NRL. He would be playing Origin.
I reckon he'd be playing Origin. For sure he'd be there.
Who does he drop out? Probably not.
No, I didn't say that.
Who drops out for him?
As long as his form warrants it. But
Boyd Coyne.
If his form, yeah, form warrants it, then he's probably there because he's played there before.
More than
likely.
So imagine this coming out, which it is kind of on the eve of Origin, if he'd been playing all time as pick for Origin. Like,
yeah.
How bad does that look for the game? I think this is an absolute... This is a hats off to the no-fault stand-down policy.
Yeah, I thought about it today, about like how it would have looked for the game. And it would have looked really ordinary. And sort of now that he has been stood down, it can just be let pass. Like,
he's
yeah.
done pass now.
Oh, yeah, his career's
sure.
over.
Because it's a charge that typically through the court systems they're saying will take 12 to 18 months. The first one.
Yeah.
There's
two more.
And now there's two more. So you take him out of the game for 12 to 18 months, he doesn't get another run, he's done.
This,
I think. Oh, that's my...
I agree.
It's over.
I'm
yeah.
going with no, it's not over. Surely they can get all these charges out in the one hearing.
But it depends, mate. What if someone else comes through? Like, you've got to have a blanket coverage for people. Like, but this brings into question what you've been talking about is what happens to St. George now? Like, surely...
Poor old St. George.
Surely they get some sort of remuneration or something like that.
Yeah, well, they can't. Is it still coming out of the salary cap? Are they
yeah.
paying him
yep.
and then not getting that to use that money, even if it is over a long period of time?
Yeah.
Well, that's ridiculous, because St. George are basically getting penalised. I know that they have some responsibility over their players, but they can't get this much penalty for three or four. Like, this could go on for his entire contract.
This could go on for 4 or 5 years.
Hopefully it doesn't, though. Hopefully it's over. Like, I would hate to see his career over. He's only a young sort of bloke. He wouldn't be that old. How old would he be?
I know, that's what I started looking up, and then I went to the...
He's 27.
Just... Is he?
Yep.
Wikipedia.
Yeah, I think he's done. I think it's over, unfortunately, for him.
Trying to get back into a side at 30, like, he'd be...
Yeah, it's tough.
We'll probably see him up here at times.
Jack de Bellen, 28 years.
Okay.
17th of March, 1991.
17th of March. Oh, so he was 27 when he was charged. Okay, got it.
Yeah, so
that's
30. Yeah, he'll be doing it tough, but...
Yeah.
And I just checked the thing. It's the same person. They've said here, just to try and clarify it a little bit, I guess, for anyone that, well, I don't know, you were interested, would it?
Yeah, it doesn't make sense to me.
Two additional charges. Each of the three charges includes the description that the Bellen was in the company of another person.
Yep.
Oh, he's understood that they relate to individual acts committed by the Bellen during the same encounter that gave rise to the original charge. So, I don't know. I don't even want to speculate.
Is Callum Sinclair a player?
Yeah, he's in trouble too. He's got... Yeah,
he
still have a Sharks.
He was there.
He was there.
Oh, he was there. Yeah.
So, yeah.
So, is he a witness or is he getting charged
he's
as well?
He's also been charged with one count. And I'm not sure if he's got the others. But
does Jack de Bellen have a girlfriend?
Yeah, he had a bird walking in with him the first court case or something.
Not this one?
Maybe not this one.
I don't know. I don't want to speculate too much.
We're not speculating. We're just
all the best, Jack de Bellen. Hopefully you're back. Hopefully you get cleared. That'll be the best thing for
hopefully,
you.
Hopefully you're in. Hopefully you didn't do it.
Hopefully he's innocent.
And you know what, though? You've got to be careful with that stuff because the head of the NRLPA came out, head of St. George came out, everyone said that he'll be innocent, he'll be cleared, this is what it... Then to get hit by another two charges, I think we need to make sure that we don't speculate, and we don't, but the people from these clubs need to make sure that they're not coming out saying, oh, we hope that he's back and playing, we hope this, because really, we hope he did commit these crimes.
Sure, definitely. That's what we want. That's ideally
that's
what we want.
Yeah.
Are you excited about the NBA finals starting this week?
I'm excited. I tell you who's getting me very excited.
The Drizzy Drake?
Nah.
Oh,
Drizzy on the
sidelines. Well, Kawhi Leonard, because Drizzy's wrapping him up.
Yeah.
He's a freak, Kawhi Leonard, isn't
he? He is bringing back that mid-range game.
Is he going to... Is he... Like... Who do we think is going to be in the finals?
The finals
is happening.
Oh, is it? I was going to say, is it Quepters Warriors?
So do you guys know about the Drake curse, though?
Yeah, because he wears other teams' shit.
Yeah, and they keep losing.
Yeah.
Then I just need him to wear a Liverpool jersey. So this might be a thing. Warriors win because the Drizzy Drake...
So but Drizzy was a Toronto supporter.
Yeah,
oh, he's a huge Toronto supporter, yeah. But he's been wearing these... For different sports, he's been wearing...
Alabama before the college championships.
Ajax before the Tottenham game. Man City before the Tottenham game.
We need to mail him a Geelong jersey.
We're going to mail him a Liverpool jersey too.
We don't have to mail him a Panthers one.
No, they're doing a good job of losing themselves.
Freaking
so, you know, this Thursday next week, shall we?
I'll remember that.
So,
are you the burner in our team?
I'm the burner.
There's another burner in our team.
Someone
that's got burned on Monday night.
Oh, sorry,
I thought you were
talking
about something else. Yeah,
and your brother Brady.
I'm putting him on those jokes. I'm going to stop throwing passes if they're going to...
Yeah, you put him in and you put his brother in and they both back
the
shit out of you.
Yeah, gave you some heat after the game.
They threw you plenty of shade. But do you know your Raptors are a favourite to actually win this first game?
I love the Raptors. Go the Raptors.
Is it in Toronto?
It's in Toronto. Well, Golden State have... Like, very
this.
Short price to win the series. But Toronto have home court advantage. So, if they're going to be in favour... Well, they have they have 4 out of the 7 games.
Mm.
If it does go to 7 games, could be Toronto knocking off Golden State's mantle.
You been watching it?
Oh, and Kevin Durant is not playing the first game. So, that's probably why.
Oh, that's not really...
who's in? Bogut? The
but
big one.
He's been playing.
Has he? That's
he's
what I'm
playing,
asking.
Yeah. So, you know, he was in the NBA. He was in the NBL.
He was in the NBL
this year. He was playing for Sydney Kings, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was playing for Sydney Kings.
What about that kid that was meant to be like top five pick to go to any college he wanted, and he chose the New Zealand Breakers?
Oh, yeah. And do you know who
What's
else?
His name? AJ something.
Brexit.
Yeah, I heard about that today. But do you know there's other rumours about the New Zealand Breakers? Who else might be going there?
Don't say Luke Hilton.
Carmelo.
For real?
Oh, yeah, that's what I read. So yeah,
wait,
he's...
Wait.
RJ
Carmelo
Hampton.
Yeah. He's OKC. Brilliant.
He was at OKC. He's been at the Knicks. He's been at...
Was he at Miami at this stage?
No, he wasn't at Miami. But he started off at the Nuggets. The Nuggets. Then he went to OKC. Then he went to the Knicks, and then he came back to OKC, and that's been it. But now he might end up with the New Zealand Breakers.
That get some people on.
That'd be so cool.
I'd watch him if they come up here to play the Gold Coast Suns.
Definitely
in a game of Gaelic basketball.
Is there
football.
A Gold Coast team?
No.
Okay.
We could make him. There's Brisbane out of team, so
Brisbane
we could make the trophy out.
Oh, what's the Heat? No, Brisbane. No, it's the BBL. Rollers?
Used to be the
Gold Coast Rollers. There
NBL,
used to be a team here called the Gold Coast Rollers.
NBL Futures, Outright Markets. I'm just trying to find out the Brisbane Bullets.
Bullets.
The Bullets.
Go the Bullets.
Go the Bullets.
Yeah, so RJ Hampton is this kid who, this huge top five prospect for the colleges. I think he had all of them offer him to go play basketball there. And for some reason, he's
great.
Why would they decide to not go to college?
Because they get paid.
So he'll get paid, and then he'll go, like, can he just play, like, a year for the Breakers and go straight into NBA?
Yeah, he can.
I feel like the college route would be cool, but...
They don't get paid.
They don't get paid, but yes...
So what they do get paid.
Yeah.
You do play, and
what do you mean a baller in college?
He'd be playing better players in the college system than he will be in the NBA. But
probably
it hasn't worked out. A few people have done it, but it hasn't worked out very well. But he can go straight from school to NBA now.
High school to NBA.
I don't know.
Or did they change that rule?
I don't think they can.
Because LeBron did and Kobe did, but maybe they changed it.
Can't he just go to like Duke and they can put his uncle on the couch?
Yeah, you have to spend 1 year in the college system, I reckon now. But yeah, Kobe and LeBron did go straight.
Well, he's not going to college.
But they must have
maybe
some
type
of
grades.
Didn't one of the balls?
Age.
Didn't one of the Lonzo balls playing go and play? Why is he? One of them's playing.
Yeah, one of them's in
Slovakia.
Europe. Yeah.
That's. I think that's got something to do
Slovakia.
With it.
Slovakia. Where's that?
Eastern Europe.
Well, you reckon? Do you remember our days back playing basketball?
In Eastern
we
Europe.
Played, yeah, Eastern Europe. Yeah, we played in the team called Wolfpack.
The Wolfpack.
Oh,
yeah, the Wolfpack.
Very
We made two grand
finals.
And
we
didn't win them.
Yeah.
And we beat that team. The first play we ever the Wolfpack played was a tip off. They did a tip off and it landed in this guy's arms and he dunked it.
Yeah.
A guy hold on.
From
your team or
no, not from our team. He really set the tone.
That
was really
the first play of us going basketball.
That's terrible.
We got flogged. But, I tell you the truth, we ended up beating that team. Remember? To get into the grand final.
Yeah, we did.
And we nearly fought them.
Yeah.
Do you
remember?
Yeah,
there was a few words around the car park and
did you put the end around someone?
No, I didn't. But I said that they were choking at the end.
Oh, no, because I have a story about a friend of ours who we've mentioned on this podcast plenty of times, but I won't mention him. We used to play in a mixed netball teams with all our wives. And at one stage, he... started fighting a bloke on the ground. Like, they were rolling over and grabbing each other's throats and things like that.
At
and
mixed
then,
netball.
This is mixed netball at Mont St. Angelo High School in North Sydney. We were, like, this is 4 years ago. This is not like when we were kids.
I played mixed netball with mine. Actually
there you go.
Kids.
So,
fun.
And then I think, and I'm sitting there, mate, this was a full-on fight. This is our very last game before we moved to the Gold Coast. This was a full-on fight. And then suddenly, the other bloke in the team, it was his brother, this big guy came over to me, and suddenly we're fighting. The whole game got called off. So our last...
Abandoned.
Our last game of mixed netball got abandoned.
It's probably the first and last fight that I ever had in netball.
No, mate, I'm telling you now.
Yeah, it gets narky.
No, because it's their sport. Like, that's the only... These guys aren't, I used to play football and now I just play netball for a bit of fun. These guys take it so seriously.
Oh, it was me.
That would be you, actually. I've seen shades of you at touch rugby league.
Where... I have a competitive spirit.
Get the fucking ball!
I didn't say that. He does get very angry.
Very angry.
The Borgster.
I was very...
Talk!
You were angry.
Oh,
not that angry.
You were angry, yeah.
Don't talk in defence.
I just keep... I got angry.
What are you going to say? I've got white socks.
That's right.
I got white socks.
White socks, hat.
That's right.
It makes all the difference.
At one stage, on Monday, I said that I've got cream shirt.
They all have cream shirt.
And
I like to throw a bit of shade when I'm doing it too.
I don't know what you both said. What?
That's
throw
okay.
Shade. What does that mean?
Like, diss them a little bit.
Shade.
Oh.
Yeah.
Throw shade.
I've got the fat ugly guy.
I'm a ginger or.
Oh,
you
okay.
Know,
I got the ninja.
Or the small fella. No one likes that. It's good. I use it a bit. I'm tactical.
Little fella.
I'm with small hands.
Yeah.
I got small hands.
That's it.
That's good. I'm going to do that.
What about when the other team were calling me Superman?
Did they?
Yeah.
Because he had a Superman shirt on that we've asked
him
to wear 2 weeks.
Because
two
I
weeks in
a
row. Two weeks in a row he's been asked to specifically not wear.
Head over to our
shirt.
Instagram page at the Leg Up Australia and have a look what Blake
yeah,
wears.
Don't look too long, it hurts
it's
the eyes.
It's disgraceful.
I bust out of that shirt.
Yeah. Alright, what do you want to call
that shirt is actually an extra large?
No.
Sure.
Both women's.
We're from baby. It's 000.
It really is. It's extra large.
Yeah,
it's
ages 4 to 6.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't look at that, but it is an extra large. We will be partying very hard when
well,
we win the grand final.
Speaking of, perfect segue. I saw you read the board. Tell us about Damien or Damion?
Damion Flower.
Is it really an O at the back end of that?
Yeah, I think it's Damion.
That could also just be a spelling mistake.
I feel like that's a mistake.
Did
anyway,
you see?
Tell us about Flower. What's he done, BJ?
So the thing they put over on news.com?
No, it was puns.com.
So Damion Flower is a massive horse owner.
Yeah, he owns plenty of horses. The most famous horse
yeah.
that he's had was Schnitzel. So Schnitzel's now a stallion.
Yeah.
What would a Schnitzel load be? We learned this word. What is it?
A service.
Yeah.
What's
a Schnitzel service?
But it must be worth
200.
About 400, I reckon. 400, because it says in this article that Schnitzel turns over about 40 million a year for Damien Flower.
Wow.
And
he's been caught. What was he doing now? What's he done?
Oh, he's been smuggling drugs on.
What a dope.
From South America or something like
but
that
yeah,
on commercial flights.
How much of this 40 million is he potentially getting? If he owns the horse.
Oh, I think he's got at least a 50% share.
So he's getting plenty of money.
From Snitzel, yeah.
And then smuggling drugs.
Let's just say. Accused.
He's definitely accused.
I don't think he did it.
I would say that he didn't do it either.
Mm. I suggest he's got enough money, he probably doesn't need to do
yeah,
it.
That's
I don't
huge,
know.
Isn't it?
But this photo, that looks incriminating.
Yeah, the punters, the guys, we know a few punters.com.au people listen. What was the brief when you had to find that photo? Was it, let's see if we can find a photo of this bloke that
yeah,
looks as much of a drug dealer as possible.
See if he's ever gone to Bali or Thailand.
Get
see
him
if
on the way
you can
home.
Get something, yeah, on the way home.
What's the key to it?
Snap the Oakley sunglasses.
The Oakley sunglasses on top of the head.
Yeah.
Aren't they colloquially called speed deals?
They are actually called that.
Bald head, open shirt, Oakley sunglasses. See if you can get that. Draw and barrier 12.
Yeah,
I don't know. I don't know where this was taken, but maybe a golden slipper barrier draw or something like that.
It's got something to do with the like the Sydney airport drug trafficking ring. So he had like baggage handlers. There's
what
another bloke. Yeah, there's another bloke that's been convicted as well.
Accused.
Sorry, you're right. He's been. Is that the word?
Yeah,
he hasn't been convicted. Sorry, he's been arrested on suspicion. His name is. Have a look. It's on the last line of that article.
On the last line of this article?
Yeah.
Okay. Tuatuo
Junior Mafita, 50, he apparently was using his airside access pass to pick up just literally bags of cocaine. We're in the wrong gig.
I have nothing to say.
We work way too hard. But at least we're not getting locked up.
Yeah, we also don't go to jail for the jobs we do day to day.
We would never do anything like that. But if there's any baggage handlers listening.
Damn us.
Don't DM me. DM to, don't do it while we go.
Slide straight into the leg up DMs.
Don't do that.
Yeah, so that is massive. So he was arrested only like last week. And yeah, it was a flight coming back from South Africa.
And you're an owner.
Yep.
How do you feel if you had a horse with Damien Flower? So he's got like 50
co-owners. Yeah.
Co-owners who are not going to get to race their horses now. Because...
So let's just break this down, massive doomsday scenario. So everything... Australia is very strong with the... what's the word? Not victims of crime, but the like fruits of crime.
So, oh yeah.
Oh yeah. You can't like take benefits.
Yeah. Crime. Benefits from crime. So let's say they pull him up and they say, "Hey, listen,
Flowey's
been doing this for the last 20 years. Every horse he owns has been funded
from this drug cartel.
And let's not use a real scenario because that's." Putting, sound like we're, you know, saying that he did it. So let's use Mr. Smith. He has 50 horses, including Parmigiana, which is a massive horse that's worth $40 million a year. What?
We've really separated these two situations. So
let's say his name is Jamie and Plant. Do they? What happened to those horses? Like, what? This could actually be massive.
Yeah, I really don't know what happens to the horses.
No, they don't dispose
them. Do you know?
We'll have the animal rights message.
He's got an Everest slot.
Yeah, I know.
So,
well, that'll be.
That's worth $500,000 or something. So, Racing New South Wales.
What happened?
Yes, no. Racing New South Wales are going to have a conversation about it. What they're going to do with that slot, but they're probably going to sell it. So that they've already sort of half getting rid of his stuff.
Yeah.
So I don't know what that means,
but what
I suggest that they have to do it because the race is coming up soon. So something they can't
do nothing.
They can't just have an empty slot.
This is. I think we'll be talking about this in the coming weeks. I think this could be huge.
We'll learn more soon enough.
Yeah.
Let's put this one on the shelf and we'll come back to it.
Puns.com, put a less incriminating photo.
Yeah, let's give the bloke a chance.
Jim Rose.
No. Jamie and Plant.
Jamie.
Yeah, get a better photo of the bloke. Hey, we're doing the podcast a bit differently now. You're now going to receive two podcasts. Well, we're trying something at the moment, listeners. Yeah. So... We'd love your feedback on it. We're going to do two podcasts. So this one that you've just listened to
still
is...
a little bit more to go.
We're... What else are we going to talk about?
It's Champions League.
When's that on?
Sunday. This Sunday, Tottenham will potentially be holding probably the greatest European trophy in football world.
All right, listeners.
We'll cover it. So next...
And I... this is big news. I know you guys aren't. Football, soccer.
Oh, hold on. Aren't I coming in with the crew?
You can if you'd like.
You coming? Tottenham
Hot
Kisses.
The Hot Kisses.
Yeah. What time are we meeting at the... So, hold on. For anyone
the word's gone out, don't get there at 5 when it starts.
Hold on.
They want you there from 11 p.m.
I'll be there then.
Or 3 a.m.
To 5 a.m.
Yeah, when it starts.
So, let's just fill the listeners in. So, you're a part of a crew called the Tottenham Hot Kisses.
Tottenham Hotspur, and we're called Oz Spurs, so it's Australian-based Spurs supporters.
Tell them how you greet each other.
We shake hands. We like other beers. There's speculation only in this room.
Eskimo kisses?
Some sort of
kissing. No. Okay, so what are they saying? So they're saying, get there at 11,
PM.
Kiss,
Like kissing's optional.
So that 11 PM Saturday night for a 5 AM game Sunday morning.
Mate.
They're gonna be blind.
This is like, just, you know, this is serious stuff. This ain't no, oh, I don't mind DC, I bought his shoes. This is for real.
I'll tell you now, how can it really be for real? None of these people are from
Tottenham. If it is, you know, actually, I'll tell you how for real it is. When I went to, when I first met these guys, they were talking about it, and everyone was, it was a little bit of a pissing competition, and people were talking about, oh, you know, oh, when I was in Tottenham, this, they're all kind of expats. One of them said...
Oh, are they? So they are people from Tottenham?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But one of them said that a guy he met in London over there and said, oh, you know, you're from Australia, you don't get it. You don't get football over here. He's like, no, I'm a big fan. And he's like, if your mate goes for Chelsea, would you glass him? And he said, no, he's my mate. He said, well, you don't get it. That's how it is here. Your mates go for your team, if you don't, you glass him. And that was for real.
I know.
Yeah, you worked in a pub there. You wouldn't know what it's like.
Well, you also remember I was part of the Chelsea old firm.
You weren't part of anyone.
Old football.
Did you kill anyone?
Don't say that. Look, in results of injury, you know, we used to go through there. What's the other one we used to
do? Broke a couple of fingers.
Yeah, we used to do the, I told you about, I used to throw the sand in their eyes.
Kick them in the nuts.
Oh, have you guys seen Peaky Blinders?
No, I don't like it.
See, but they've got those little hats with the blades in it. Yeah. Where do you think that started? Me.
In the movie?
Me.
Oh, it's fictional. Boogie. What were you going to say? Because I was going to say... Interrupted.
Can you show us how serious you are
and into the microphone give us like a celebration of a goal?
He's
like
sounding like one to yell on the mic.
Yeah, why don't
we? But you've got to be careful with your levels because they went
red. No, yeah. But I love what I'll say. There'll be lots of singing on Sunday. Get prepared for that.
What's a song? Come on, give us a song.
Come on, give us the Spurs.
No, please.
Oh, man, you're going to make me... I want to make sure I get the lyrics right.
Don't worry about the lyrics. No, yeah, none of the hot kissers are listening. They won't kick you out of the group.
You'll never...
No, that's Liverpool.
You'll never walk alone.
You don't know that song.
Yeah, that was really hard. No, they sing a song about...
Blowing bubbles.
Bubbles are trouble.
That's... You don't know the song.
You don't know any of the songs that sing.
Bubbles is... West Ham.
What do you guys do at half-time?
No, so we do one about the lane. We are Tottenham, super Tottenham. We are Tottenham from the lane.
White Hart Lane. Justin Lane?
Nope. Pizza Place.
You've been to White Hart Lane, haven't you?
I've been there. I haven't watched the game there.
Me neither.
Very upset about
it. Do you guys do shots after every goal?
No, I mean, they go crazy. They'll throw the beers around.
Do they? Do they really go nuts?
Oh, I had an out-of-body experience when we scored a goal in the last final.
What'd you do? You serviced.
I was No, it will be incredible. I can't wait.
How many
and there's heaps of
Liverpool
supporters in
How many people are going to be there?
I've got no idea.
Would they be upset if Sam and I turned up in Liverpool jerseys?
No, there's going to be heaps of Liverpool supporters there. You won't be able to sit at the top.
Who's the most hated team by Tottenham and Liverpool?
So Liverpool hate Everton because they're a stone's throw away from each other, the Merseyside sides. And Tottenham hate Arsenal. And Arsenal are playing in the...
You go with Arsenal,
dare.
I'm going
to
go with...
No, actually don't, because that'll be actually a very bad idea.
Oh, do you reckon it'll kick off?
Oh, for sure.
Really?
Yeah, I seriously don't do that.
I wish them all the best.
Oh, here we go. When the championship wrapped up, I was talking about it's the richest game in sport was played only the other day.
Oh, that's to get not
to take
the other
final
game, the other
spot
way. Yeah,
promotion.
It's something like
Villa.
200 million talk. Like Aussie.
Yeah, Aussie, it's 250 million or something.
Far out.
So Aston Villa got that spot over Derby, which is, there's some connections in there that are pretty crazy too with ex players and coaches and stuff.
Oh,
but
really? Imagine the pressure of that game.
Remember Jednak?
He's an Aussie captain.
He was the Aussie captain, not anymore.
Who is?
I was school with him.
Did you really?
He was a year above me. We went to play soccer together. No, he went on the holiday in Malta once. Does that count?
In Minchinberry.
Rudy Hill. We're at school.
Rudy Hill.
Yeah, St. Agnes. St. Agnes High.
Oh, shout out to Yedders. Oh, was that his nickname?
Well, funnily enough...
Knackers.
No, we're going Jednak. But he was always known as Michael. Michael Jednak. No, I didn't know about Mille till later in life.
Oh, mate, he could have just fanned himself a little bit more.
Maybe, I feel
that's
like that.
That's huge. Imagine, I was thinking about this as well when you were telling me about it. Do they give the players like $1 million each?
I don't know how it works. I'd imagine no. There'd just be a purse, because now they've got to go into the big leagues. They're going to spend
up. Yeah, they're
going to
spend all that money.
They're going to spend up. Some players.
This, so what they get to go into the EPL now is more than twice than the winner of the Champions League will get.
What? What?
Yeah.
Really?
Villa.
Good Villa have been there before.
Let's follow
Villa.
Yeah,
one of those ones.
You
should follow Villa.
No, mate. I'm a Chelsea
ultra. I'm
going to
go for Villa.
I'm Chelsea
ultra. Because I don't have a team, so I'm going to go for Villa.
You get glass.
Hey,
you nearly went for Arsenal a second ago.
I'm going to go for Arsenal on Sunday night. But
they're not playing. They're playing
and it's Sunday morning.
Actually, and
turn off Sunday night.
They are playing against Chelsea, your team that you love apparently, that you don't know about their play, in the Europa League, in a country that no one wants to go to, and
New
all
Zealand.
The photos are very funny, that like the pictures on the side of a hill and stuff. They're playing in like Uzbekistan or something, and they've stuck this like 4,000 Chelsea people going. Oh, sorry, Arsenal people going. And they're returning their tickets. They're not even going. So, Chelsea and Arsenal supporters, have a good hard look at yourselves.
So
London is lily white, bitches.
Oh. Is he throwing shade? Is that shade?
That's a bit
of shade.
He looked at me and said,
don't you dare go for Arsenal out of spite. Because that's disgusting.
Arsenal are good. I used to like Freddie.
You have to buy an Arsenal jersey tonight if you need to get.
I'm
gonna
get a Ljungberg one, like old school. What do you think about that?
Or
well,
Henri, Thierry Henri.
Would he get glass? No, we won't. That does.
I'm
a
scientific
question.
Man.
Sorry.
So when people say things that are like, oh, 200%, 100% is the maximum. 100%. If you come in at Arsenal, but number
people
one, I'm not gonna look at you or talk to you. Number two. You will get pounded.
Like,
there will be Arsenal supporters there. So when I go to the, I go to the casino to watch the Tottenham games.
Yeah.
There's usually a small group of Arsenal supporters who just sit there and pick at the Tottenham supporters.
Do they?
Yeah.
And it's
not.
They won't be there on Sunday morning.
They
won't
be. But if they are, I recommend don't do that.
This is going to. I'm going to go.
It'll
turn
on.
I need to see if this kicks off.
Yeah, I need to see.
You won't give 100%.
You have to start working.
He won't go.
He
won't go.
I don't know where Thierry Henry is.
I might see if I can catch the front end of everyone. 11 o'clock at the casino.
I'm going to rock up at maybe 4:00.
Have you been at that casino at like...
been there for 3 o'clock game.
3 a.m.?
Yeah, you were there with me. When was
it?
Oh, you were watching...
that wasn't 3 o'clock.
Yeah, because Cardiff...
No way.
Did
you play some roulette or blackjack?
Mate,
did
it is a sad sight, the Gold Coast Casino, that early in the morning.
Mm.
I've been like one of the last to leave, which is weird because it's a casino that's open 24 hours, but it does feel like you're the only one in there. Hey, we'll let you know how we go with that.
Yeah, that'd be...
Hey, can I get back to explaining, or do you want to explain what's going on with the podcast these days?
No, you can. I thought you were going to miss out the ramble stuff, and that was important to get out.
I was.
I thought anyway.
Sorry.
I'm real riled up, actually.
I'm glad.
Look up an Arsenal song. So the way we're doing a bit different, we've got a lot of people that are really interested in our bets. We're going to do a separate podcast for our bets. So this one is just more your kind of chat, and we'd love to get your feedback on it and ask us any questions and things like that that we can talk about.
Don't write in and say, just do bets.
Well, they can because
just listen to the other
podcast. Yeah, listen to the other podcast. I think it's going to be called The Bet Slip.
Something like that.
You'll see it come up in your feed as well. It'll be recorded straight after this, but it's just it separates what we're doing because we find it's a much easier thing to do time management.
What are we
going to
call this one?
This is still just the leg up episode 13.
Oh,
so,
okay.
So let us know. We're just going to trial it for a while. See what you guys think. Hit us up on Facebook or Instagram, The Leg Up Australia, and let us know if you want it all back into one, or are you happy with the two different ones. So keep an eye out for that. Thanks for listening. Episode 13 wrapped up, boys. BJ, thank you.
Yeah, the boys.
Borgi.
Fire Borgi on Sunday.
Fire blood pressure, and then I'll have all
you
day.
You are angry.
Don't be angry.
I love it, though.
Don't be spiteful there.
That's the bloody welcome to the hot kisses.
No,
top hot kisses.
Alright,
later, guys. Alright, cheers, guys.
till I can't no more.